Marketing and promotion is imperative in a store closing sale. And it's not a matter of making a decision to have a store closing sale and throwing up some signs on the door and maybe making a post on social media. No, it's way more complex than that. If your goal is to walk away with your head held high, not turn your store into a circus, and walk away profitably. If these things are your goal, any of the above or all of the above, then marketing and promotion is critical. And that's whether I'm involved or not. By working with me, you get the benefit of my expertise, not only in the store closing process, but in marketing and promotion. So my system that I implement on your behalf, it includes buying triggers. It includes customer psychology. I understand what makes people buy. I understand what gets people to your store, not just once, but over and over and over again. There's social media ads. Sometimes we place them dark. Sometimes we place them public. There's a whole arsenal of marketing that's being put to work for you behind the scenes. And your marketing budget is going to be commensurate with the size of your inventory, the size of the project, which is why I recommend everybody who is looking into the store closing process to schedule a free, discreet, private consultation with me directly. You'll speak directly with me. I want to learn more about your situation. I will break it down for you. I'll break it down with you, piece by piece, part by part, to fully understand where you're at, what your situation is, what your inventory is like, what your store is like, where it's located. There's a lot of information that's transpired during a consultation call with me. And we will assess exactly how much advertising budget you're going to need during the course of the whole sale. Understand that the marketing budget, it's not paid for up front. It's paid for as you go along. And that's not my consulting fees. That's the marketing and promotion fees. So as a general rule of thumb, depending on the size of your inventory, you can just take your inventory cost and estimate about 3 to 15% of that cost is going to be your advertising marketing budget. So if you have a very large inventory, you know, because I've worked with clients who have millions of dollars of inventory. I've worked with clients who have $25,000, $30,000 of inventory at cost. So if you have a large inventory and you're watching this video, don't automatically attach 15% to that because you're going to be at the lower end of that spectrum. If you have a very small inventory, then your advertising budget is going to be at the higher end of that spectrum.